Okay, so how do I go about teaching or learning a language? Well, that's a loaded question. There are many answers. You could say some people need to learn a language as they're moving to a new country. Some people need to do it because of their job. Some people simply for tourism. Others for personal development. Others because of a new relationship. Other people to pass an exam. Whatever the answer is, you need to ask yourself this question. You need to break this down. If I say to you, I want to learn Italian to go on holiday, that's too vague. It's not precise enough. So the first part of this is, you don't really need to learn a language. You need to be focused on how you acquire the language. So to give you some context on this, I usually use a thing called SMART objectives, which is from the business world, and these are objectives which are specific, measurable, attainable, relevant, and time-bound, S-M-A-R-T. So, I need to learn Italian to go on holiday. It's not precise. So, first of all, I need to learn Italian for tourists, to undertake an Italian for tourists course. Or perhaps I need to learn the most 1,000 most frequently used words in Italian to get some vocabulary. That's specific. I might need to know Italian for hotels, restaurants, car hire, asking directions, buying food, and complaining. So these are measurable, relevant, and specific objectives. I only have 8 months to do this. Well, I can do this in 8 months. It's attainable. And also 8 months is time bound. So this gives me a clearly defined goal to find a course relevant to my requirements, a course which contains the content that I need, a course which can be completed in the relevant time frame. All in all, I need an Italian course for tourists which meets my requirements and can be taken in 8 months before I travel to Italy. Now, you need to do this with your English, and that's where I help you. We make the goals SMART, specific, measurable, attainable, realistic, and time bound. And if we have a goal, we will achieve it. So what we're looking at again here is motivation. Quite often my teaching colleagues ask me, how can I motivate my students? The answer is, using traditional teaching methods, you can't. Motivation is intrinsic. It comes from within. It's not extrinsic. It doesn't come from outside. By asking how can I motivate my students, we're confusing motivation with inspiration. But the best way to motivate students is clearly defined goals, an objective that's reachable, because you need to specify goals. Otherwise, how are you going to succeed? When learning a language, your goal should not be, I'm going to learn English. You cannot learn English. I've been speaking English for 45 years. I've been teaching it for a very long time. And there are still new words that I learn probably every week. And this would be the same case for you in your mother tongue. So you need to break your goals down into manageable chunks. Alternatively, you need to decide what the purpose of your learning is. Are you learning in order to get the most out of travel? Do you need the language for work? If so, what area of your work? Is it presentations? Is it online meetings? Is it selling products? Is it dealing with suppliers? Is it dealing with colleagues in different countries? Also, are you going to go and live in another country? Even with all of these goals in mind, this overall objective needs to be broken down into small, manageable chunks. So a professional language teacher or language coach, such as myself, will help do this. If you don't have clear objectives, you can't make a clear plan. And this is what's called willful blindness. So if you have a vision, which with all things considered will work and be achievable, then you can set your overall objectives. It becomes a question of just chipping away and continuing to achieve it. And this is where micro routines come into effect. For example, when I planned and began learning a language, there's no language fairy, there's no god of language that comes and brings this language into my mind. I needed clear objectives and micro routines. So to do this, as I do with my students, I'll set a completion date. We'll agree a completion date, possibly in Google Calendar or something like that. Then add the micro routines, scheduled events in the calendar which are non-negotiable and are dedicated study times with clear objectives. And you manage this like you would a working day. So you've got your main purpose that you want to learn English for. So we have to be clear. Then we make a simple calculation of how much time this is going to take, what the micro routines are that we're going to do, and that motivates you. So we don't agree an unrealistic schedule. We use the SMART model. We don't want to have a punishing routine, because if it's punishing, well, by definition, you're not going to enjoy the process. You could be a very conscientious person, somewhat of a perfectionist. So this really helps manage your time and your learning. Having said that, some people say that perfection leads to paralysis and you just need to get on and do it. But we develop the routines and we develop the learning and coaching as we go along. We don't want to create a prison for you by employing a schedule that's too overbearing or too difficult or unrealistic. The idea is we meet your objectives in a controlled, manageable, fun way. It does not turn into a tyranny. So that's kind of the process of objective setting. That's what I would do when helping people to learn a language, when helping people to study a language. And as I said, you've got to be truthful. As I asked at the beginning, what do you need English for? Because you'll never learn 100% of your own language, let alone another one. So we ask that question, what do you need English for? Then we break this objective down into controllable, achievable, manageable chunks. Okay, any questions, please ask in the comments section below. If you'd like to book a trial lesson, please feel free to email me, or perhaps buy me a coffee in the link below. Thank you very much. Goodbye.